Hello, greetings and salutations. I hope this finds you well. Today, I just wanted to talk about this thought slash living experiment that I've been doing for the last week. So the last week, I have been doing my best to collect as much of the waste that I generated from my day-to-day activities, the type of, stuff that we basically have the opportunity to either not, engage in creating waste during all these different, activities that we have throughout our daily lives, or we participate in them. And then this was just kind of an experiment to see, to make me more mindful of these everyday, very simple, kind of automatic decisions that we make that end up generating quite a bit of waste. So I wanted to do this to reflect back on how much waste I'm contributing, as well as finding ways that I would be able to limit the amount of waste that I would be creating, because less waste create, the better off the planet will be. And that's important, as the planet's not in good health. The health of the people will quickly decline after, I think. So, with that said, this is more or less the amount of trash or waste that I created over a week. The first couple of days, I forgot to bring a washcloth or reusable towel with me to work. So when I, wash my hands after going to the bathroom, use paper towels. So this would look a little bit bigger. But there's also some things in here that normally I wouldn't generate during the week. These surgical wipe things I'd use for surgery, plastic, but not something I'll often have to be using, hopefully. And then I did share a coconut water earlier with Rosa, so technically half that bottle would be mine. I'm going to try to reuse this in some way, because plastics are horrible. So my portion of the dryer lint for this week, not really sure what to do with that. Bunch of receipts, grocery shopping, so I took half because, we're shopping for two people. Another receipt, PCC, Kleenex, receipt from Costco, PCC, parking at the airport, rolling paper, Kleenex, receipts, floss paper, floss, actual floss, more Kleenex or toilet paper to blow my nose, same with that, and a sticker from a lemon, more tissue, receipt, tissue. This is the gummy bear we took off at the food forest, plastic. Let's see, plastic from a raisin bag, Q-tip, keep the ears clean sometimes. This was wrapped around, I could save this actually. This was wrapped around some carrots we got from the farmer's market. We can save that, repurpose it. Another part of a receipt, more Q-tips. Another joint paper, a little piece of plastic, not sure where that was from, but it's in there, so I generated it. More tissue, more Q-tips, some stickers from fruit. And I think that is it. Let's see, and some gum, and some more dryer lint. And then we also have another, I think, a sticker from a potato. This was just the bag I was using, but this will go back in the cupboard for future use, because you can definitely get quite a bit of use out of these Ziplocs if we not get rid of that quite yet. So all that stuff was about 3.5 ounces, so not too bad. I heard Rob Greenfield say that the average American creates about 4 pounds of trash each day, and he did this really cool kind of experiment in New York one month. Whenever he went out in public, he would wear all of the trash on him that he generated for that whole month. And he usually lives, you know, quite sustainably. Check him out on, you know, YouTube, different social media. He had some really cool stuff around, you know, reducing our impact and zero waste and creating positive change, that type of stuff. Rob Greenfield, check him out. But anyways, he wore all of his trash out in public around New York for a month, and he was eating, or living, I should say, like the average typical American, so it was generating a lot of waste. And this kind of got me wanting to not quite go that route of wearing my, you know, waste in public, but just to dig a little deeper into how my everyday, you know, choices from like brushing my teeth, you know, the floss, you know, that's a waste product, or, you know, Q-tips, coconut water, receipts at the store. Let's see, what else do we have here? Gum even, but not horrible. I mean, I didn't generate a whole lot, and if that statistic's true, which I definitely think it's more than 3.5 ounces a week, which is about what this is, you know, but I still have some room for improvement, and it would be really cool to try to go 1 week and generate no waste at all as far as everyday kind of everyday life choices go, you know, like cooking, brushing your teeth, shopping, that type of stuff. So you know, just something I wanted to do to see how much I could cut back, but also see where after the week was over to see what different areas that maybe I could dig a little deeper on and seek even further improvement in those areas. As well as, so Rob Greenfield was one of the inspirations for me to try this, as well as the book Radical Simplicity. Super good book, highly recommend checking it out. Jim Merkle's the author, it's awesome. Go get a copy, go get one from the library. But yeah, so that was how much waste or trash. Okay, well, not all of that's trash. Some of it can be recycled, like these receipts. The paper can be recycled, I think, most of it at least. I don't know about toilet paper, but I'm gonna try it anyways. But recycling's good. It's better than it just going straight into, you know, the garbage dump. But oftentimes, you know, there's quite a bit of energy costs related to recycling, so it's not ideal. It's better to reduce or reuse, and then, you know, if you reduce and reuse as much as you can, then if you really have to, then recycle. Just because, like I said, the energy efficiency of recycling is not very good. Oftentimes it's being, I think a lot of stuff from the United States used to be, at least what I heard, used to be shipped over to China and recycle, but they stopped taking that stuff from us, so that might be one of the issues. But yeah, it's better just to reduce and reuse as opposed to kind of creating these new waste cycles, if you will. So that is kind of what I wanted to say about this. It just kind of got me inspired to, like I said, seek further change and improvement, and of how I am able to live as a sustainable human, or at least working towards that on our planet. Because if us, especially us in the developed world, United States in particular, if we don't make some radical changes in how we live, how we interact with the earth, how we interact with each other, with ourselves even, then the long-term prognosis for our for our well-being, our well-being and our sustained well-being on our planet, I don't think is very good, but the good thing is that we all have power in the choices that we make every day, as far as, you know, like shopping, you know, riding your bike, walking more, just being more mindful, being more kind, being more loving, being more open-minded. You know, there's so many ways that we can affect and create positive change in the world, and I encourage you to, you know, dig deeper and find some ways that we can all collectively come together and improve as an overall, you know, kind of just general humanity. But I hope this video finds you well. Me and Clarence are signing out. Be kind to the planet, be kind to the animals, be kind to each other, and be kind to ourselves. Much love, and let's find some ways to affect some positive change.